Dr. Ramanujan and my dear colleagues of the department, good morning to you all. Today I would like you people to listen to the notion of collocation. I would like you to get introduced to the notion of collocations today. And I would like you people to open the vocabulary builder at page number 35. Well, have you ever listened to this term called collocations any time in your life? And do you know what a phrasal verb is?
Yes.
Do you know what an idiom is? I think you understand what a notion of idiom is and a collocation. I mean, and a phrasal verb is. And you might also, to some extent, say what a commonly confused word is. What are the differences between commonly confused words? But if I ask you a question on what a collocation is, what is your idea on collocation, you may not be able to say. Though you know it internally, but then you will not be able to tell me what you mean by collocation. So for that, we will just look at two contexts so that you will have a clear idea of what a collocation is. And you will also get to know whether these collocations exist in English, in Telugu, and even in other languages also. So let us take that handout and look at the context. These contexts, you know, these are real life contexts and they're spoken by students in our own class. Student number one, I heard student number one saying, "Your hair looks soft and shining. What did you do to your hair?" The second student said, "You see, the day before yesterday was the second Saturday and it was a holiday. So, on that day, I kept henna to my hair." Yes? So how do you translate that, this keep henna? Henna. Can you please translate this combination of keeping henna in English into Telugu? This is English and this is Telugu. How do you translate this into Telugu? Yeah, henna pettukodam. So, henna and pettukodam, they can go together in Telugu. But do you think in English, keeping and henna can go together? Is this a natural combination for us? Yeah, we say henna pettukunnanu. This is a natural combination for us. But do you think this is a natural combination or unnatural combination?
Unnatural.
So this is an unnatural combination. So keep and henna in English, they don't go together. So what can we say in order to make it, you know, correct one, an acceptable combination? What can we say?
Applying.
Exactly, applying henna. You apply henna to your hair and you don't keep henna. You don't take the lump of henna and you don't keep it on your hair. So, you know, the meaning is understood, no doubt. But the combination is not the right combination. Sometimes it's very humorous if I listen or if you listen to someone saying, "I kept henna to my hair." For the next one. And on Saturday, I put oil to my hair. Put oil in English. The combination, the girl said, was put oil. In Telugu, what do you say?
Oil
pettukodam. Yes? So pettukodam is put. So you can't place the bottle of oil on your head and put oil. Again, you can correct this combination. Is this a natural, does it appear to be a natural combination or unnatural combination? Unnatural again. Here, it is natural for us. But this may not be natural in English. This becomes unnatural. So this is not the right combination. So oil and pettukodam can go together. So this becomes a natural combination of words, which means this oil and pettukodam, they can collocate, they can combine, but put and oil cannot combine. So this natural combination of word is nothing but a collocation. Here, they can't go together. So we are just trying to translate Telugu words, Telugu combinations into English. And that's why we are able to make mistakes. And I mean, say students are trying to make mistakes here because they are trying to literally translate the word combinations. So here we can understand that in a language, it has got, every language has got its own combinations. So we cannot translate that combinations, those combinations of the word into English. So then we tend to make mistakes if we literally translate. And she says, today I did head bath. Okay? So this is something again. This is a sentence most of the students say. I did head bath today. In Telugu, how do you translate this doing head bath? Talasnanam chayadam. Talasnanam chayadam. So chayadam is do for us. Okay? So can I say I did head bath? So does it appear to be a natural combination? Again, it is an unnatural combination. Uncommon combination. So how can we correct this? Do head bath.
To wash hair.
To wash hair and then you take a head bath. You take a head bath. So for us, do means chayadam. But we don't know that in English, chayadam has got different meanings like do, take and make also. Okay? Of course, they are synonymous, but then every word cannot go with do. Some words they take, some words they take make. But for us, all the time, chayadam means do only. So we always concentrate on this do and we tend to make mistakes like doing head bath. Okay? And second context, student number one says, hey Krishna, I did a phone call to you. Again, do phone call. In Telugu, what do you say? How do you translate it? Phone chayadam again. Phone chayadam. Okay? So again, it is do for us. But do you do a phone call?
No.
Do you do a phone call?
No.
So it is an unnatural combination again. This do and phone call cannot collocate, they don't go together. Of course, the meaning I told you, the meaning is very much clear. But the combination is not the right combination. What do you say? How do you correct it?
Me.
Exactly. You make a phone call. You don't do a phone call, you make a phone call. Okay? But I told you, for us, chayadam is always do. And so we don't think about making. And we don't think about taking also. But we always have, you know, stuck up with only one word called do. And he says in the next sentence, you didn't lift my call. Okay? How do you translate that lifting phone call in Telugu? Phone yettaledu, yes. Lift call is lift call here, sorry. Lift call is phone yettadam. So do you really go to the phone and then you lift it? You don't lift it. So for yettadam means for us lifting only. So we are trying to translate it literally into English and you are saying lifting call. But do you think it's a natural, does it sound good if I say he's lifting the call, lifting the call? How can I correct it?
Pick
the call or?
Answer.
Exactly, answer, pick, answer, take the call. Okay.
Can we say attend a call?
Attend a call, why not? Attend a call. But then for us, yattadam means lifting only, truly translating. Okay? So, this combination is natural combination for us. But this is an unnatural combination in English. So this translation, you know, business tends us to construct unacceptable sentence. Next, say student number two. At that time, I was catching water. So, catch water. Can you translate that into Telugu? Catch water?
Water,
pattukodu. Water, pattukodu. So this is a natural combination for us. Water can be, pattukodu. We can go and, we can do this process of pattukodu, water pattukodu. But in English, if I say I'm catching water, and I have to run after it, and then I should catch it. So is it appearing to be a natural combination? Sometimes, you know, it is very, very humorous if somebody says, I am catching water. But can you correct this collocation? This combination of words, catching water, they don't go together.
Holding water.
Can you hold water?
Fetch.
Exactly, fetch water.
Can you say collect?
Collect, yes. And then, you can draw water also from the well. Draw water, collect water, fetch water.
Store water.
Store water. Preserve water. And so on we have. But we can't catch the water as we did in Telugu. So this is a natural combination for us. But in English this is an unnatural combination. Which means every language has got its own natural combinations. But if we tend to translate them truly, then we are prone to make mistakes. The meaning is clear. I mean everybody can understand. But it would be humorous to say I'm catching water. The next one. Sorry, I forgot to call you. I did a mistake. Did mistake. Translation into Telugu? Tappu cheyadam. Again, cheyadam only. Cheyadam. Cheyadam is always do for us. So, we don't think about another word called make. So, if you have to correct it, you say, you?
Make
a mistake. So, do and mistake, they don't collocate, they don't go together. So, this is an unnatural combination, but here in Telugu, it is a natural combination. Okay? So, from this discussion, you might have known what a collocation is. What is a collocation now?
Natural.
It's a natural combination of words, a common combination of words, or a predictable combination of words. If I say water, you can predict different combinations to the word. So that is, so you are clear now with the notion of what a collocation is. So collocation, you know what it is, you have the idea of what a collocation is. And next one, my question is, can we truly translate Telugu collocations into English? No. So which means, collocations are natural and they have to be learnt as they are. You cannot try to or tend to translate one language's collocations into others. If at all we do so, we are prone to make such kind of mistakes. So they have to be learnt naturally and as they are. Okay? So thank you for listening to me and we will start reading that introduction on collocations and you will have a fair idea on what a collocation is. Thank you so much.